Hey guys, Skid here, welcome back to Stories, The Path of Destinies. So, I don't know what to do to unlock the last truth, so I'm just gonna go with whatever. Let's do the Renardo one again.
Lupino.
Or apparently Lupino
the
one again.
Sold a Pegasus that he did not exactly own.
Let's skip that, I've heard that already before. So, maybe there's a different pathway I can take, or something I can do. Maybe it'll allow me to... I don't know. There's gotta be a choice that I can make that changes the outcome of something.
Lupino had apparently managed to confuse the judge by arguing that he hadn't actually stolen a winged horse. He'd only sold it. Wait, where was the prison? The village was empty. Had everybody fled the ravens?
Ow! Crap. That was a lot of ravens.
People were frightened these days. Just 2 weeks passed, Renardo had sneaked through an empty town and listened to the ravens call about the Emperor's new taste in ritual sacrifice.
Oh, Everything I didn't see him.
Hurt. And then it didn't.
I didn't see him. My bad.
Renardo looked around the empty village and reflected. The Sky Ripper had turned out to be far too dangerous to be used. Time to turn to what he knew best.
I guess I need to get more distance before doing something like that. And again. Boom. Jeez.
Boy, someone has spent a lot of money for a graduation present.
I got another thing. I need to heal. Whoa! Hold on. You guys came back? Boom, you're dead. Okay. Music in this game is so good. I need to download the soundtrack. Such good music, man.
Once, he found a Superman issue number 1 in mint condition in a jar he'd broken. He planned to keep breaking things until he had the whole series.
There we go. Learned that last bit of sword foo. And a workbench. So I can equip that third gem that I got. Oh wait, your attacks have a 10% chance to deal double damage, increases resistance to spell damage by 20%. I didn't notice I had multiples. Should I do elemental or should I do critical? Let's do critical chance. Sounds good to me. I'm low on health. Hello, I can use a fire sword on you.
He hadn't noticed that path before.
It's because I didn't have the fire sword before. Shoo. Shoo. Haha. Another gem. Treasure Hunter level 3. Nice. I got an achievement called Bling Master. How appropriate. So, this way? No, not that way. Oh, wait, what is this? I don't remember seeing this. Maybe this is the pathway I need to go. For the story to change. I mean, the game will probably lead me through what I need to do. More than likely.
Killer! Kill the rebel!
Cord, Van Raven.
They eat the rebel!
Cord, another.
Close your eye. I'm dead. That sucks. Come on. Restart from checkpoint. Thank you. I should have used the magic. I wasn't thinking. That was nice.
Ravens were landing everywhere. The advance guard. He'd better get moving. If they got to Lupino first, they'd eat him for breakfast. Or a snack. Ravens weren't picky. If they got hungry, they sometimes forgot to interrogate their prisoners. Even top spies like Lupino. Well, unless he really was a traitor, obviously. Then they'd probably pin a medal on his chest.
Ow!
It was good to practice your moves, thought Renato. Keeps you limber.
Now I need to heal. That's energy. Don't need energy. I need to heal. Oh wait, there's Lupino right there.
Dirty and bloody, Renato finally reached Lupino. The rabbit was practicing his shuffle. Renato recognized the cards. It was Lupino's favorite deck. Oh, I thought you were in danger. I am. The ravens are coming. Oh, the prison thing. Right, yeah, we see this guard owed me 53 ducats, so we made a deal. They're very reasonable people, actually, for weasels. Now, I got a brilliant plan to kidnap Zenobia. We capture Zenobia, we find out what she knows, and that's the whole war right there. Easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Capture the Emperor's greatest general, who also happened to be a
so
deadly sorcerer
different.
And, oh, his only daughter? That would be worth it. On the other hand, he could still get to the core of the Sky Ripper, even if he couldn't get the whole thing. It must have great power.
I'm gonna
Zenobia
go for Zenobia.
Wasn't just the Emperor's daughter, of
There's
course.
Gotta be something more with Zenobia.
She'd been Renato's best friend in Swordfu School, and you're still mad for her.
I've seen this. There's gotta be more.
The city was already under Zenobia's control. I had to admire her efficiency. Renato shivered at the thought of Zenobia at the mercy of the interrogators. Could he really turn her over to them?
Maybe I'm supposed to.
It wasn't meant to be pretty.
Okay, hold on. Before I go through there, is there anything this way? There is. I guess I'm gonna skip that, Hello. Skip that door. What?
Done a barrel roll, he thought, as he
I
died.
Should have done a barrel roll. Ha ha! Very funny. Die. I should have done a barrel roll, he thought as he died. That was... The jokes in this game are just ridiculous.
If they didn't want their things broken, they really ought to make them stronger.
Okay, so here's another fire door that I wouldn't have been able to go through before. So I'm gonna go through this fire door. Hello. Whoa! Ah, okay. So it's just a chest. Physical resistance. Gym. Alright. That could be useful. But, no, I have the, I have the critical chance. So, I'm okay with all that I have, all the gems that I'm using right now.
Why was Lupino urging him to capture Zenobia? Obviously it was a trap. But you never knew how Lupino thought. Sometimes his plans were so convoluted they did the exact opposite to what Lupino wanted. Yeah, there must be some way to play on that, Renardo thought.
That's new. I don't remember him that happening before.
Boy, it looks to kill.
Energy on kill level 3, nice. Oh, there's Lupino. Wow, that transported me right
so,
to the end.
What's this plan of yours? Use me as bait, said Lupino. And he outlined a slightly complicated plan that involved geese, a net, setting the farfare a little bit on fire, Lupino dressing as an old blind toad, and Renardo hiding inside a monstrous watermelon. What could possibly go wrong? Thought Renardo.
Let's do this one.
Oh, go ahead. I'm sure you know better, said Lupino.
So wait, didn't the mission end there last time? I'm so confused.
The new pathway made Renardo curious.
It makes me curious too. Let's, hold on a minute. 5 sword energy? I don't need that. Let's do the physical resistance over the sword energy one. Hello? Nice! Oh, energy,
the rock
energy.
Felt hot in his hand. He could feel its secret power.
And elemental resistance level 2. What is this? There's no base. You're not in the chambers ready to spend your last night before. Well, you know, I will not apologize. I know you were too proud to forgive me. I also know you won't resist reading the through. You are a cat. As much as I have tried to educate you like a proper toad, I swear to you, and you have to believe me, that I did not plan all this when I adopted you. You always have been my special little kitten. Oh, Zenobia was adopted. That is why I'm writing this now. Weeks in advance, I know I will not have the heart to do the night of the sacrifice. If I think of you as my daughter, then I may change my mind. You must think I am selfish, and yes, I am a selfish, sad little toad that is afraid to die, but what I am doing will ultimately serve the greater good. I want the power. I want it all. So I'll keep my subjects content, peace for eternity. Even if you hate me now, you can still respect that. You have to. It is the only way I can forgive myself for doing this to you. I will miss you for eternity. Tomorrow, try not to make a scene. Everyone will be watching still. With love, Father. Zenobia was adopted. Holy crap. Is that it? Yeah, okay, I know. It's another gym, right? Let's just look. Go look at it. Alright. There. So, now what do I do? Okay.
Renato slinked through Zenobia's ship, making no sound at all. Where were her guards? Finally, he reached her bedroom. She was curled up at her bed. Oh, he'd forgotten how beautiful she was. How sleek. How soft. He tapped her on the shoulder with his sword. She became smoke. And he noticed he had a blade to his throat.
Stay a while,
heard a familiar voice. Did you really think you could capture me? Zenobia said as her ship lifted off.
No,
I just wanted some privacy, Renato said. Did you ever wonder why the Emperor adopted you? And he told her why. His Imperial Majesty wanted to bring the lost gods back. They could make him immortal. But to seal the bargain, he needed a sacrifice. Someone who truly loved him.
You're lying.
She was furious. You can't prove that. I can. And so we set sail for the Nexus.
Interesting. 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 Things are getting very interesting. I wonder if this is going to be like, after I reveal the last truth, if that's going to be the ending, or if this is going to be like another thing I got to play through. Just we'll see.
The scientists at the observatory have resurrected one of his victims. Well, he's not exactly alive, but it can talk and it can't lie. You took a big risk. You know, I could just cast a spell to make you tell me where the rebel base is. And you wouldn't consider that cheating? She frowned. Ugh, fine. Let's go get your witness. The rebellion had started after atrocities that the Empire hushed up. Renato had rescued a priest whose order had been massacred for one book. He had slept in a burnt village. Dead kittens and puppies had come to tell him what the Emperor had done to them.
Okay, so this is all new to me. I mean, not this level. I think I've seen this level before, but the whole thing with Zenobia is brand new. That's kind of cool. So maybe see, the game kind of is holding my hand in a way.
Ice walls only let you through if they knew you were cool.
And well, I am cool, so let's go through. I wonder. Yep. I wanted to grab the chest first. Anyway, yeah, the game's, like, I figured the game wouldn't just leave you, you know, stranded and be like, okay, you gotta figure this shit out yourself. Which sometimes I prefer in a game, when it lets you figure stuff out for yourself, but sometimes I just want to play through the game and get the story and have it done, you know? So, it's kind of like half and half for me sometimes. Hello. Ow. Ow. Cross and the Fox is what it says. Open says me.
Not everyone knew how to use magical gems. Of course, not everyone had magical gem gauntlets like he did.
Good point. Oh, another thing. At school, we learned the gospel of the Transcendent Emperor, like the last divinity to pierce the skies. He would banish the evil old gods and grant us the gift of time. But could one man, divine as he may be, create something as intricate as time? I have my own theory. I believe the time is a symptom rather than a gift. I'm convinced at the cosmic scale that there's a pendulum motion between order and chaos. Transcendent Emperor ended chaos and started the age we live in, an age of cause and effect, of fact and logic. Time sorry, is merely the tapestry upon which these laws manifest themselves. It is the foundation of Order's companion, Entropy. But in the Age of Chaos, when the old gods reign, perception carries more weight than facts. Emotions can shape worlds and time ceases to exist. The Age of Order is ending. I am merely helping the inevitable. Entropy has been broken. Fate has been breached. The end of time is coming, and I shall embrace it, Emperor. Interesting. There's so much more to this, like, story than I ever thought there was going to be. I like it, though. I thought it was just going to be a simple...
He once met a pirate captain. He used hooks to get around his ship. Oh, what was his name again?
Was it Captain Hook? Am I supposed to go up? Oh, okay, here we go. So all that down there was just for nothing. It was just me exploring and collecting goodies. Or it wasn't for nothing, but you know. Bitch! Hello, chest.
There were a lot of shiny, smooth, and curved with leather.
She caught up with him.
Oh.
Don't you think I'd know if my father started practicing black magic? Why? Would you want to join in?
Oh, no, I'd destroy his books and...
All right, I suppose I wouldn't.
She stopped, troubled. He ran on.
Okay.
Ever felt you were just going around in circles? Bernardo felt like that.
Spin to win. Hello. All right, so gems. Physical resistance, critical chance. I've got Shieldbreaker. Your hits causes shield grunts to drop the shield. That'll be a lot easier to do than just grabbing and hitting, but no. I would like attack speed, actually. Attack speed is the one I want most of all. But, oh well.
Imagine if you built a house of one of these things. Oh, that would be amazing. It would be like having a boat.
A houseboat? Also, that hit me and did some damage. That sucked. Whoa! Did that hit me, too? That's lame. Ah! Oh, come on, just grab the thing. Go. Alright. Oh god. Okay. That's kind of cool. The sliding around I just did. That was awesome. Yeah. That was awesome. That was that one hit sword foo coming in. That one hit kill sword foo, that was awesome. I need to upgrade that again. So it requires less of a combo to do. That was awesome. Whoa. Wait, didn't I go through there before? See, the game is kind of letting me know, like, look, you did this last time, or is it, or wait. What is this?
The observatory was a burning hulk. Dead scientists and black feathers everywhere. The Ravens had taken care to burn the reanimated witness to cinders. Zenobia stared around, shocked. The scientists had been neutral. They had no part in the rebellion. Take me to your council, she said, shaken. I have things to tell them. It was what Renardo had gambled on. The Zenobia would turn against her father once she knew his madness. But the rebel base was secret. Could he really risk taking the Emperor's daughter there?
I'm gonna trust Zenobia.
Renata reached Lupino by Farspeaker Toad, the one creature the Ravens had left alive at the observatory.
Lupino seemed awfully anxious to meet him at the secret base. If he was a spy for the Empire, he'd turn around and reveal the coordinates to the Empire, jeopardizing the entire rebellion. But Renata couldn't bear to think that Lupino would commit such horrible treachery.
But he will.
There was still good in the Mad Rabbit. He felt sure of it.
I'll meet up with you at the base, Lupino said through the toad. Good thinking. Renardo gave him the coordinates. There's a shuttle here I can borrow.
Renardo found Zenobia in the chart room.
I've been having awful dreams, she said. Dead kittens and worse. I thought there were only dreams, you know. Why would anyone want the lost gods back in those days? The favorite of a god could become immortal. She held herself and shivered. He wants to become an eater of souls. Well, I'm not afraid of dying. Just dying of boredom. Renato said, but she didn't laugh.
Silence fell as they flew towards the ruins of the city of Ubar, where the rebellion leadership was hiding. If Zenobia couldn't help them fight off her father, no one could.
So here goes. Ooh. Cool.
As they touched the ground, he could smell the ravens and hear their hungry caws in the distance.
They're probably looking for me, she said. You go on ahead. She had that fiery look in her eyes that he'd always loved. It was a bit odd, though, how easy she'd been to convince. It was what he'd gambled on, but he'd expected more of an argument. She'd always loved to argue. She considered it the fastest way to the truth. Maybe she'd long suspected the truth. Sometimes all it took was taking the bandages from your eyes. That must be it, he told himself.
I hope I didn't screw up or anything. I always worry that I screw up. Like, I'm always, like, every episode so far, I've always been worrying that I, like, chose the wrong ending. That's the bad thing about multiple endings for me sometimes, is I'm always worrying. Especially like in the case of like playing Skyrim, I had thought about doing Skyrim for my channel. In fact, I
of all the artisans he was creating employment for, truly, he was a job creator.
I did about 15 episodes of Skyrim on my channel, and the reason why I stopped is because when it comes to games where I am me personally, when it comes to games where I'm giving multiple choices, like Skyrim especially, I tend to save and restart and reload a lot.
Interrupted story time.
Cord to leave, Raven.
I will never find out if it ends.
So I thought that if I did Skyrim, that would be, it would end up being an extremely long playthrough, because all I would do is constantly like choose something and then reload, and then choose the other option, and if I didn't like it, then I'd reload again, and I feel like that would be a crappy thing to watch. That's the reason why I haven't done, the reason why I didn't do Skyrim. Well, there's a level up.
They caught their breath under a ruined arch.
It's beautiful, she said. This was the library of Ubar, he said. Your father's ravens thought they had an ancient book. She nodded.
Was she crying? This was exactly what I wanted, Renata thought. To turn her to our cause. So, why do I feel something is terribly wrong?
Because nothing ever goes this smoothly, is why.
I'm sorry, Zenobia. Sorry about your father. That hurt.
Who are you looking at? Oh, right. No one.
Okay. Oh, boy. Okay. I'm glad there's a checkpoint there. Alright. That was a lot easier than the first time.
As for the gate, well, he could take her or leave her. Sorry. It's best I could do.
You should have just stayed quiet. Shouldn't even have tried. That's all I have to say about that. Probably the ending right there. Let's, I want to go through this ice door though. I want to see what's through here.
I wonder what happens if I go that way.
Well, we're about to find out. Ah, it's a chest. And shoot. Oh, I was hoping to get all of them. Well, health, and critical chance too. Not bad. Hold on, let me grab that. Thank you. Alright, I guess that's it. Okay. That's interesting. Secret base?
The council toads swarmed around Zenobia, shocked she was there, shocked she had changed sides. Then the walls exploded. He heard toads croaking, "Oh, the ravens!" Blackbirds were pouring through holes everywhere.
Oh,
it's
no.
A trap! cried.
So Zenobia did betray me?
In the confusion, he saw flashes of magic. Then Zenobia being hustled off by Imperial troops. So, she had betrayed him after all.
Damn.
Renato ran for his ship. The Farfarer flew into the clouds, barely losing the Imperial Ravens pursuing him. The rebellion was lost. And he had lost
either it. That or Lupino.
There was nothing to do but find Zenobia and make her pay for her treachery. His heart ached. He still loved her. But he had trusted her and he had been a fool.
I bet you.
She would be back at the fleet, gloating with her mad, bloodthirsty father. For all Renato knew, she was helping him bring back the old lost gods back from their exile.
I bet you Zenobia is fine. I bet you it was since, you know, he told the coordinates to Lupino that, you know, because Lupino is the traitor, that he gave the coordinates to the Imperial army. And then they broke in, killed everybody, and kidnapped Zenobia. So she's probably fine.
In the middle of the Imperial fleet, the rebels were losing badly. Without leadership, it was a slaughter. Renato felt strangely free, trying not to think about how he had lost the war, trying not to think about how he had loved Zenobia, blinded himself to her treachery. That's what it meant to be a hero, to keep on fighting after the most bitter of betrayals, to never know if you could trust anyone. Cats, what a waste of fur.
All right. So, I'm gonna do my second sword
nice.
Fu.
That could be useful.
That will be useful. Shieldbreaker level 2. Nice. Okay, let's get through this level, get it done. I don't think Zenobia would really want to help her father because she would have to be sacrificed.
And the mad rabbit fled to safety? Or was he forlornly carrying on like the few rebels Renato could see here or there? Ugh, it didn't matter anymore. All there was slash and spin, parry and lunge, over and over as he fought his way across the fleet. All there was finding the girl he'd once loved, who had used his love against him and putting as big a hole in her heart as he left in his.
Damn it.
I should go, he thought.
The battles are really, honestly, getting a lot harder. Maybe I should equip the Shieldbreaker. Okay.
There was an engraving. Maximum capacity, 130 people.
Come on. Thank you. The battles are getting really tough. At least it... The game's... Oh my god, look at all the shield bearers. What the hell?
There were still so many games to play.
Oh my god.
Renato thought as he died.
This is getting frustrating. Oh my god, just stop. Just stop.
Just getting warmed up, he thought.
there. The battles are getting a lot tougher. Either that or I'm just getting worse, because I'm tired. Wait. This time I'm going along here again. So now I'm on the flagship. This is the flagship right here. That's it.
And suddenly, Zenobia was there, advancing a Lupino. So the mad rabbit had survived.
Save me, or I'm done for! Screamed Lupino.
Zenobia turned, showing her teeth in a smile.
You're alive!
Renardo ran towards the witch.
Lupino's the one who betrayed you, she shouted. He warned my father!
Before he could think, Renardo sank his sword into
the
sorcerer.
Oh no!
She stared at him, heart broken.
No! Lupino's the traitor!
Renardo had an awful sinking feeling in his stomach. Then he felt a knife in his back.
Yep.
I'm afraid she's right,
to the mad rabbit.
Ain't I a stinker?
Then the sun went out.
Damn.
Damn it.
So did I just get the wrong ending?
He hadn't learned anything new this time.
No!
He'd done the same thing twice, yet expected a different outcome.
Maybe I should have done... Okay. Well... So the game isn't holding my hand.
There would be a way to win. Renardo could
damn.
He'd have to explore choices.
Screw you, Lupino.
Before he could figure it all out.
Though. Okay.
And with that, the book's pages fluttered to the beginning once again. And he fell. The clouds parted over the Isles of Boreas. It was time to choose. The rebellion was in trouble.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. All right, blah,
Ravens
blah, blah.
Were scouting for the
Thank you guys for watching.
Base.
I'm going to play through this off screen and
Pieces
make it back to that
surfaced.
Point. Yeah, here we go.
Renardo knew that using it could go catastrophically wrong, but he was sure he could figure out how to use it safely. Also, a temple had risen out of empty desert. The Iblis Stone was hidden there. It was a dangerous artifact. It could corrupt its user into a bloodthirsty monster. Maybe he could find a way to use it. To take its power without surrendering to its wickedness.
I wish you could
and
skip
also,
this.
His old friend Lupino needed rescuing. Of course. Renardo had a pretty strong suspicion that Lupino had betrayed the rebellion. But could Renardo really leave an old friend to the Ravens?
Okie doke. Alright, so I'm going to end the episode here. I'm going to continue this off screen. I'm going to try and get back to that point where I could have made the choice between trusting Zenobia or not going to the rebellion or not going to the rebel base. And I'm going to see if that makes a difference. Thank you guys so much for watching. And subscribe for more. Hit that like button. Leave a comment down below. And I will see you guys next time.